Nagami. Once we got the Shin title, then it kind of became closer to its current format.
Yeah, it's got like strategy maps now, right?
Sort of. They've always never been the kind of dungeon crawly, like first person dungeon crawly, but they were a lot more. The story aspect didn't really come as heavily until they got the Shin title to it.
Yeah, once they weren't tied to a novel.
Yeah.
They could actually make their own thing.
Is this the game with Michael Jackson in it?
No.
All games have Michael Jackson in it.
One of the Shin Megami Tensei games has Michael Jackson in it.
I'm sure it did. This one didn't. I'm pretty sure it didn't.
Look, there's a reason we don't talk about Megami Tensei before the Shin title came along. The books are...
a thing.
A thing. Yeah, that's the best way to say it.
Looks like... Devil Survivor. Let me see.
Look, you're gonna...
I know there
there's
was
probably...
one... I was gonna say,
Devil
I know
Summoner
one...
2. There's a tribute to Michael Jackson in it.
Yeah, so that's Devil Summoner 2. That's probably Soul Hack?
Raito Kuzunoha versus King Abaddon.
Ah, yeah, that's... There's a lot of spin-offs to Megaten, and it's kind of confusing. Like, the biggest one is, like, as it says on the thing, Persona.
Yep.
But even then, that only really became... That only ate the rest of the series after Persona 3... Well, Persona 4. 3 was very popular, but it was 4 that really hit and got its, like its thing. Granted,
3 is
4...
3 was more Wolf 3D, and 4 was more Doom.
Yeah, I remember 3 being pretty popular. And so I think they just doubled down on everything that was in 3 for 4 and then 5, and that's why those are the big ones now.
Yes. there are issues about 3 and 4. Well, the head writer of 3, 4, and 5 is not a good person, and that's that's a story for another time.
Also, Dick Monster.
Yes, Mara doesn't show up until, like, much like Shin... get... 2, maybe?
Shin 2, I think?
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Can't wait for that.
But, again, that's Mara's...
Mara's good
yes,
people.
Yes, Tyrion.
Yeah, Mara,
kind of a prick, but
yeah,
still good people.
Mara's just, hey, it's a giant penis on a chariot. That's all it is. There's no, like story equivalents.
And you just, you can't get any more pure than a penis on a chariot. I mean...
Well, again, what people associate with Persona now about the school thing, that's Persona 3, 4, and 5. Persona 1 and 2 are... They're technically involved... Well, Persona 1 technically is a school, but that's because the entire school got trapped in the demon realm and you're trying to get out. And Persona 2... There's a lot to unpack about Persona 2.
Well, every game has to include a dating sim now, I've discovered.
Are you talking just in general the series, or just Persona?
So Persona, you have to build up your relationship, because, you know, Yuki will now die for you. And then, only recently I've been poking with Danganronpa, which has a dating sim in it, and the latest Souls-like Code Vein released, and it has a dating sim in it.
Danganronpa does not have a dating sim. I've been... There are, like, sure, there's, like, the whole build, give gifts to people, but there's no, like,
That's
alternative
what I mean.
In it.
Give gifts to people... to increase your relationship so you can unlock more unlockables. That's what I will, like, that's a thing now.
Okay, okay, that's fair. I was, because when you say dating sim, I think of, like, multiple routes, that kind of aspect, when it's, like, Danganronpa is very, very linear as a story. It has one definite
ending. You have to give people gifts to increase your relationship. Like, it's even in freaking Code Vein, which cracks me up.
See, Danganronpa's pretty good, but they get a little trigger happy, for my liking.
Fuck off.
That's exactly the reaction I want.
Like I said, I like the life manager aspects in 3 onwards, but I can understand why It's also part of the reason why I enjoy Three Houses as much as I do.
Oh, Lolo, you didn't see the awesome picture I posted that made Carnival very happy about Pokemon.
God, fucking damn it.
Hold on, let me post it in images.
But yeah, I'm kind of interested to see what they do for Shin Megami Tensei 5, just because it looks like it's...
Is that all that Full Alchemist is going to be known for now?
Yes! You fucking know it, and it's a shame.
There's like good characters like General Armstrong and like actual good stuff.
Got some for Armstrong, too.
But no, it's the dog girl morph that everyone's going to know that thing from.
I mean, that point in it is, like, so freaking traumatic. It comes out of absolutely nowhere, and it hits so hard. So, yeah.
Look, it's the same way that Control-Alt-Delete will always be known for Lost.
Yeah.
Even though there's probably much worse things that happen, those lines are gonna be whatever it's known for.
Yeah. Which, to be although, I kind of agree with Lolo, and I kind of rebut yours, like, the only thing that Control-Alt-Delete deserves to be remembered for is Lost, whereas Full Metal Alchemist, it is a shame that more of the other stuff isn't as prominent
I would argue that it doesn't even need to be remembered for Lost.
You're not wrong, but it's
at some point we can stop making fun of the poorly written storyline and the really shitty edits that people do.
I've started replacing the word "lost" with the actual the actual lines.
With one L, what was it? One, two, line, L.
Yeah, and
something like that.
Chachi, you're right. I hate it because the show itself is very good at showing like this is bad. This is entirety of its like militaristic functions is really bad, but.
Because I thought that was part of the story was not so much that it was fetishizing Nazism, but that it was trying to hammer home the point that military authoritarianism is bad and will always break down because it is bad.
Yes, but remember, this is... People don't read. People don't know how to dissect a plot for themes and things like that.
Also, the second point being extremely painfully true.
Yes, that one I can't rebut. It's sad. Yeah. It's fucking...
Where did my phone go?
Just have to redub. That's all. We'll get Steve Bloom to go in. Everything will be fine. Steve Bloom makes everything better.
Steve Bloom wouldn't... we need to find another voice that would fit well for Ed.
I want Spike Spiegel's voice on Ed. You can't take this from me. Just like I want him to just overdub every character in Inuyasha, because would make me happy.
The problem with him being named Ed is the first Ed that I thought of was Single D from Ed, Edd n Eddy. Just imagine that voice on him would be great.
That'd be awesome. Man. I'm just happy that Full Metal Alchemist is only problematic for stuff that's not directly related to the writing. It's just a person that was involved in the project is the only real problem.
Yeah, that's good as compared to some other things. Better popular. And you Attack on Titan.
Don't start me to Attack on Titan! You know how I fucking hate them. God, the story itself is so blatantly anti-fascist that it's like, if you didn't know anything about the actual writer, you would think this is like this great satire on fascism, except he just complete it just... I hate it so much.
Hey, Cardinal, what are your thoughts on Isekai?
I mean, no, there's various other things.
That is bait. I'm not going.
It is.
That's bait. That's rolling on you like a giant truck, set to send you to another world. Man, that just reminded me of an idea that I had for a game that was basically LSD, except every time you went into another world, the only way you could transport to it was a giant truck that just came over and ran you over.
In a campaign I'm running that has Carnival in it, I had each of the characters face something that they hate or would find super disgusting, and Carnival plays a character who's really into anime, so I just replaced all of their copies of every anime they have with just copies of Remonster.
That's great. Yeah. Actually, those campaigns are now actually being there. You can now download those at the Boogeyman Buddies podcast.
Yes. And the first one of our campaign actually went up.
Yep, it just went up. So there's that.
Yeah. But I don't want to take up on your...
Yeah, I just had to quick put my phone up real quick.
Yeah, we are still in pre-roll, so it's fine.
Yep. Well, except for right now, when we're about to start. So,
all right, muting.
Okay. All right. So, hello, and welcome to a Sunday edition of Retro and Crapsody. October requires us to play spooky games, and this is kind of a somewhat spooky game that we're gonna have to get to this franchise eventually, since how much of a thing it is now. Like, this franchise had a really weird arc, because we were taking a look at the first game in the Megami Tensei franchise, although really now it's more referred to as the Shin Megami Tensei franchise, because this franchise actually started as kind of almost like Sweet Home, except rather than being based on a movie, Megami Tensei was based on a book, particularly a book that was written by, Aya Nishitani. It was first written in 1987. It is the first of a trilogy or at least the first one, obviously, set off a trilogy of novels that this game is based on. So there's actually technically two games that were based on this novel. The first one that came out was actually a game that was developed by Telenet Japan, collaborating with Atlus, that was released for PCs. At the time, and by PCs I mean the MSX, PC-88, those kind of things. It's actually, I think it's more of like an action RPG, kind of like the original Dragon Slayer. Like, it's kind of more bland than the one we're taking a look at today. And technically that one came out, although they were both developed at the same time. That one just happened to come to market first. But that's not the one we're taking a look at today. The one we're taking a look at is a game that was developed by Atlus. It was published by Namco, and they have their name on it. There is no mention of Atlus for some reason, although you can definitely tell it's an Atlus game. It is based on the book, although it apparently actually takes place after the book, or the trilogy of books, because they mention, you know, kind of a very loose thing, an extremely loose description of what happened in the first book, much like basically if you summarized the entirety of the original Star Wars trilogy as Luke Skywalker killed Darth Vader, that is basically the summarization that you get in this little intro bit. But it kind of goes into what it is. So I'm going to load the game up and do the intro, and then I'll kind of fill in some bits that they left out. Right off the bat, we get a monster, and it is Digital Devil Story, Megami Tensei. Which is a great name when you later release a game called Shin Megami Tensei Digital Devil Saga. That totally doesn't get confusing.
Look, these games have never been good about, like, being kind to archivists.
Yes. Fucking nerd.
So here is your kind of basic plot. Yeah, so Kemi Nakajima is your main protagonist. Basically, he uses computers to summon demons. And the predictable thing happens.
Yes. Kinda nerd programs his devil summoning program without an instant switch without...
Yeah. And Yumiko Shiragase is the other protagonist. That's also the other thing, is they just so happen to also be reincarnation of gods. Nakajima is Izanagi, and I forgot what her name was, but basically the other one is, was it Izanami?
Izanami.
Yes. Yeah, Izanami right there. So yes, basically, and then after that, they got put back, but now they're trying to break free again. And there's Lucifer. Okay. So, let's go and start. The first thing we gotta do is we actually get to actually set our stats. This is, in fact, a very much an RPG, so fitting for the rest of the series. So strength is basically what you'd kind of expect. It makes you stronger in battles. Wisdom, depending upon what character you're dealing with Nakajima, it makes him use his computer better, which essentially means that it's easier to talk to enemies and kind of get them on your side.
Oh, then you should definitely pump that.
Yeah, we should get that. Attack is basically attack strength. Agility is, I believe, ability to run. And luck is, agility is speed, essentially, who takes turn first. And luck is, I can't remember what
Does
luck
it
is, but...
critical hits?
No, it has something to do with whether or not enemies get run away or something. It's something like that. Then Yumiko. Yumiko, basically, same thing with everything else except for wisdom. That basically makes her better magic. So we're gonna
do that. Do we still have the Megaton trait of if you don't pay attention to status effects, then it will push your shit in?
Oh yeah, this is a classic kind of wizardry kind of thing where status effects really, really affect.
Okay, I just wondered if the whole, you motherfucker, you better pay attention to those weaknesses was a thing in the series since its start.
I don't think the weakness thing, the weaknesses thing is so much in this one. Let's do that. Okay. And here is us entering Daedalus. Or Daedalus. However you pronounce that. Okay, so you first start off, they just kind of plop you in here, but this is actually your first town. So
pay attention to the phase of the moon.
Yes.
It's very important.
Yes. So let me try and kind of remember. Oop. Nope, can't go in there quite yet. Oop. So yes, we do want to open that. Okay, so we got 500 maca and a jewel. Maca is very important.
It's money, and for everything.
Yes.
You need her to wield a soul so he can eat all of the kitchen eggs.
And this is Mekum Town. So yeah, basically, so there is a kind of, I don't want to call it Pokemon aspect of this, but technically this game did it first. But it is basically, under certain conditions, you can get monsters to your side. Kind of almost a similar way to Pokemon, except you don't use Pokeballs, use money. Or items.
Also, you should blaze up your money. Ah, oh, now you can't.
Get the nunchucks.
Get nunchuck armor.
Want the combat suit. Doesn't leave us with much money, but we should be good. Okay. So, first thing we want to do... Oh! Here's the other thing that's weird about this game for being an RPG. Use a password system. There's your password.
God damn!
Okay, so here's where we go to actually, you know, go deeper in this, deeper down in this tower. So, yes. So first thing we want to do is actually have Yumiko use some magic. That being using the spell Mappa, which basically gives us a mini-map. Oop, here's a battle.
Gnome! Okay.
Yeah, we do not want to deal with gnomes. Because gnomes are actually the strongest enemies on this floor, because they can cast a magic spell that does a lot of damage.
Oh, what? They're already bringing up the 9 level spells at level 1?
No, they just... magic just does a lot of damage. So yes, that is why you don't want to keep track of the moon, because they will be more dangerous during a full moon.
Yeah, wow, this is some serious wizardry here. I mean, it's even got the same kind of menu set up.
Okay, we don't want to descend quite yet. Trying to get in the... there. That's what I'm trying to get in the... oh, nope, that's not true. I'm trying to get in the outer layer. Oh, I think I see what I'm doing. Sirs, don't want to do this. I want to turn right here.
At least it gives you a map.
Okay, let's see.
Hey, Quint, the Egyptian goddess,
looks kind of like an orange Murloc.
Yeah,
yes,
kinda.
Because they didn't actually have the good art yet.
when you're playing as Nakajima, or Nakajima's terms up, you can call in monsters that you've captured. We don't have any at the moment. Or you can talk to them. However, basically, the thing with talking to them, that's how you actually get monsters to your side. Doing that when you have more than one enemy is not very smart, though, because basically they'll just not do anything. So we just gotta fight.
Now, the X3, does that mean that there's 3 of them to fight?
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
But here's, let me get Hecate's art from the current updated artwork.
If it has knives on its ass, I'm gonna hurt you.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
I'm never letting that go, by the way.
You shouldn't. But yeah, so
that's interesting. It's a Karen frog.
Well, yes, because again, Hecate was a Egyptian goddess of fertility that was synchronized with that was the frog was her symbol.
Yeah, but she's got like that Stepford Wives haircut.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, that frog looks like it's about to ask to see my manager.
Yeah, there's been a lot of design changes over the years, because...
Let's see, theoretically, I don't think we'll be able to do it properly, but just to show it off. Okay, so there, I could do that. However, if you do that, you don't get any XP, which sucks. I mean, that's what we need, so we're gonna have to kill this thing.
Oh wait, you don't- wow, that's fucking cruel! Normally you get at least something!
That's great!
Normally you get something when you do a recruit.
Nope, it's not in this one. You get the monster. Which, by the way, takes... You need to give it... Or you need to spend money in order to actually have it do anything.
Gotta get those execution points.
Actually, does she have any combat magic?
She has Medica.
She just has Medica. Medi. Okay.
Yeah, Tyrion's right. You still killed 2 of them.
Yeah, it you still don't get anything.
That's fucking bullshit.
That is archaic.
Yeah, wow. So, can you, like... if you did that while there was 3 of them, could you get 1 of them and then kill the other 2 and then get experience?
No, you basically get them all. So, I think the thing is you can't do it if there's more than 1.
That's so fucked up.
granted, considering as that it quickly gets thrown out, that's probably just a technical limitation more than anything else.
Mm.
Yeah, that was, this is the first one, and they're still thinking things through.
Yeah.
See, there.
Ah, okay.
Damn. Here we go. Let me just do that. Okay. There we go.
So yeah, the things that you see in front of the thing, like Mythic Caquet or Wild Slug, or sorry, that was Mad Slug. Those refer to like a species subgroup that they get shuffled around in later games, but that's how you, when doing fusions, you can tell that these are of the wild subtype. So we sometime later we might see the wild black dog, and that's just so you can know that these specific traits will then usually be associated with different subtypes. I don't know how that's probably not all that much here in this game yet, but
That is still in here.
Okay. Anyways,
there was a table that I saw in some guide that had that.
And I imagine the Chaos Law thing is non-existent.
No, that is a Shin Megami Shin Megami Tensei thing. Okay.
Yeah, so, that's what I figured.
Jesus. Yep. Actually, you know what? Nope. We're not gonna do this. We're gonna do...
Actually, oh, wait, you have... Actually, you don't... You can use magic.
Yeah, that's what I was just realized. I'm like, I can just do that.
Thought that said Nappa for a moment.
See, how much do you heal? Oh, that's a decent heal for a Magicka style or a Wizardry style thing, because usually that's like a 1d8. Still not the best, but I can.
That's better than what you had before.
I can still, because especially since it's only two, that's actually really cheap too. But, okay, let's see if I can, because I bet you it's not a set amount. I bet you I can. Yep.
Oh, okay.
Okay, there we go. That's better. So also I bet you this is not an RPG that will restore your full or restore your HP upon level up.
Well, you just did level up, so yeah.
Yeah, I don't think you get your difference in HP, though, is more the thing.
It just stays at whatever value it was at the time.
Yep.
Right, that's what I'm saying, is that, yeah, we saw that already.
Oop. No, no.
Oh, can you bump into the walls?
Yep. You can, but it doesn't... It's not like it hurts you.
No. I just like when they add mechanics like that, because it's stupid, but it's funny at the same time.
Okay, was there an... Okay, yeah, there was an auto.
So is that jewel command just for, like, items?
That is... What I could do with that is I can use... Because I have one jewel on me. What that'll do is I'll basically... It's a full heal.
Okay.
Okay, let's see if I can find something else. Oh no, I never did that. Let's try using the stairs. Let's use map again. Oh, also good, it's also full moon. Oh, actually, let's see. Let's fight. Talk. Oop. Let's try this. Because I'm pretty sure you can just game this. Oh yeah, you can just get the wrong way.
It's like, hey ghost, nah, fuck this.
No.
Run.
Yeah, run. That is another thing that I like about this game is that, or at least from what I've seen so far, the escape rate is incredibly high. Or likelihood.
Yeah, that's shocking.
Looks less like a slime and more like something that came out of someone's nose.
Eh, foul green slime. Something's there. Okay, so mag is a interesting concept. Basically what that does is the... Do we even have any to start with? Does that just go around? Does that just decrease normally? Mag. Okay, we have 11. So what mag does is basically, so there is a cost in order to have enemies or like to have monsters with you as you walk. But there's also, when you walk around, they will also, basically they'll lose health as you walk around. Ooh, that, okay, these things look like they can do more damage. Okay. Oh, wait. Okay. Let's give him...
Put the wisdom up to 10.
Yeah, I could. You, I will also... Put your attack up. Oh, Jesus! What the hell? Yeah,
that went wrong very quickly.
Yeah. I'm sure there is a max level, but...
We will not be reaching it.
No.
Got a pentacle on it.
Mimic? Oh.
Not quite.
See, I was wondering if it was gonna do, like, the, like, Phantasy Star route of whether or not sometimes, or the Wizardry route, in which there's just sometimes a bomb in the chest.
I wanna heal.
Yeah, let's do that. Oop. This is a little bit... The menu's a little bit unwieldy if you're not used to it. Is there...
These things hit hard.
Oh wait, that's preemptive on our end.
Yeah, it's preemptive on your end. It's normally a back... They normally give it as back attack if you get... If it's you getting...
Let's see if this... How poorly this goes. Okay, that should be fine. Yeah, there we go. But at this point. Oh wow, this barely gave anything.
We got more mag.
It gave 26 mag.
Yeah,
so
outside
that's
the
probably...
bag. Yeah.
Yeah, they're very clearly not worth fighting for experience.
Oh boy. You got preemptive, so if you...
I bet you those are not gonna be fun. Okay, I think it was this way.
God, I miss the pseudo-intellectual bullshit that their later games are going to get to.
This game gets into the philosophy of how even the easiest fights can be difficult. And life is pain.
It is a pre-90s RPG that is just standard.
No. If you want life is pain, this series is not going to ever learn.
Yeah, we could play Shin.
Yeah. Or we could be playing, like, we could play Strange Journey and it's teleport dungeon with damage floors. Because pain.
We could do those things. We could also not do those things.
We could play games like Last Bible.
Right, exactly.
not that spinoff.
Would you be lacking your time frame? What's that, Rafferty? You're, like, super low.
Last Bible Bibles. Black in the acceptable window?
Did you just say Bible Black?
Yeah, Bible Black, something else.
Okay. Have to be sure.
But Last Bible was one of the, I think, more aimed for kids. Well, more kid-friendlier spin-offs compared to your usual Megaton. Which, oh boy, we get fun things like America launching a nuke at Japan again.
I was gonna say, isn't that basically what starts the whole different routes in Shin, the first one?
I forget if that was one or two. It's probably one, you know, I think about it.
It might actually be both, now that I think about it.
Because I was thinking, like, it was either one or two that's part of the reason why this happened. Megaton's canon time... Megaton is also one of those series that all the games are canon and have happened in sequence, but don't try and figure out how.
How do I miss my map spell?
Oh, this is a fucking wizardry game. This is definitely a fucking one of these.
Do I just not have the ability to cast it a certain amount of times?
Is the seed based on, like, your where you stand, or is it...
Try that again, yeah. Whatever.
Because I was gonna say, maybe it's a moon phase thing, because I wouldn't be surprised if some kind of esoteric bullshit like this would have...
Think so.
The answer is fuck you, that's why. Look at this nerd.
Let's go down.
He's got a fork. What are you using that fork for?
Okay, let's try and capture some enemies. Oh, there's a zombie here. Okay, let's see how bad these things can be. Okay, it's just
one. Way lower than I was expecting.
17X, wow. Man.
Maybe you should just fight zombies.
Yeah. We took a good amount of damage, but... Let's see.
You only took 8 for Yumiko. And I want to say 6 for Nakajima. So that wasn't too bad.
Let's get ourselves a slug. Actually, no, I don't think Mad you can actually capture.
Plus, these things are pretty rough, if I remember correctly.
Oh, it's probably because are they casting magic? That's... No, they just do... Why do they do so much damage?
Who would have thought a slug would be more powerful than a zombie?
I would. This is Mega 10.
I don't think there's...
They're not fucking breaking out the instant death spells yet that work, like, because... God, fucking these games. they love their instant death spells that work both ways.
Okay, let's see if we can get a... Let's see. Let's try and get one of these. Nope. Suck. Let's try this.
I wonder if these can't be reasoned with. Nope.
There.
Maybe you have to beat it up a bit before it decides, hey, yeah, maybe I'll join you.
I don't think health has something to do with that.
It's... like, everything I know about these mechanics come from later games, so I can't really say, because they're usually really interesting, because sometimes, yes, you beat them up enough and they say, no, just, I'll work with you, just stop, please.
Now that I've broken both your arms and your legs, won't you join us?
Tyrion, this is long before Pokemon. This is 87. Pokemon first came out in, like, what?
Like 94?
I think it was, like, 93,
94. That was 96, I think, actually.
Okay, well.
I thought 96 was just the US release, and it was, like...
Oh, right. I think it was 95, I think. I don't think it's before 94.
1996 was the first release of Red and Blue.
Okay.
Was US or just worldwide?
In general.
Okay.
Well, Red and Green and Blue.
Yeah, because in Japan it was Red and Green, and... Don't... Just kill one of them. Okay, there we go. Fight, use computer and talk to it. There we go. Okay, so now we have one of those.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. So, Japan, it was 96 for Pocket Monsters, and then 98 for NA in Australia, and then 99 for Europe. Saw the release of all of them.
But yeah, point standing, Megaton is long before Pokemon has seen a blink in the eye.
Let's see. Let's try that again. Oh. I guess you can't kill it, or I guess you can't capture these things. Go. Okay, good. Let's see. Let's try. Try buffing our attack. Let's see, let's just hang around here and see if we can capture something else. Something written here. This is just a treasure chest.
Shame that slug's not made of metal. Shut up.
Okay, that seems to be nothing here in this corner.
I like that the stairs are in the ceiling. That's really good.
I was gonna say, there's only so many ways you can draw, like, an upward staircase. With the hardware we have.
Also true.
Like, I think this looks pretty nice for what it's... trying to do.
Yeah, in the grand scheme of things, this did come out the same year as Final Fantasy.
Huh, you're right, wow.
The presentation is fairly nice, it's a little clean, the details here and there.
Yeah, the slide back and forth, left and right, that's built into the game.
Yeah, oh, that's not deal with this thing.
Oh, wow, fuck. Kinda I wonder...
Did you try talking to it?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it did 28 damage to us.
Well. Now you know not to debate it.
Yeah, don't talk to the ghost, leave it alone.
Yes.
But I do have to say, I just... Looking at this, it's very interesting from... Seeing that seems like a lot of the base concepts that would go through for the rest of the series were kind of already nailed down here. Which, granted, it helps that it was based on a book, so they had those kind of things to go off from, but even then, so...
How do you know exactly where you're supposed to go?
Basically, we just go... as with all of these kind of things, you basically just go down.
Yeah.
You go down until you can't go down anymore.
Yeah, this is the nature of the genre. So, like, I don't mind the directionalist of this, but that's the same problem I have with most of these wizardry kind of style games of this era.
Yeah, you're either going up or you're going down.
What if I wanted to go to the left and right?
I mean, you can, but that's not going to get you progress.
Sideways and front ways, back ways.
But I get more than just...
Basically, I just want a video game about the Wonka Vader.
Do I just have the one? No, I don't.
Yeah, Tyrion, I agree that map rotating with you is kind of confusing.
Also, especially it's weird because if you take a look at it, considering that we're going south now.
Yeah, but the map's showing it south. As north.
Yeah. Also, it'd probably help if I had, because, I mean, I can just look at the map.
Oh, right, don't you have the map right next to you?
Yeah. I've been just trying to, just because I just have been remembering it when I only need to know two floors. Okay, so we are, right, because this isn't oriented. Okay, I think this is, okay, so I am, here I need to go to, okay, so I need to, should be. I actually need to heal myself first.
Kind of weird to have a spinner puzzle. I mean, those are standard wizardry, but you have an auto map, so it makes it pointless.
I don't know if they have spinner in this. Also, the thing about the music, that the music's composed well. The problem is that all Atlas games sound the same, at least, or they sound like they use the same sound engine. And games like The Karate Kid also were made by Atlas, so I keep on thinking that this is from music from a different game.
Yeah, no, this is like, if nothing else, Mega 10 games have really good music. It's just, like, their lead composer for a while, hold on, I got his name,
Let's see.
Shoji, it starts with an M, let me try and find it.
Oh.
Yeah, Shoji Meguro, who's been with... He's been... Okay, yeah. He started actually working... He's been working with Megaton from... with Atlas, but his first major work was being part of the original Persona. But he's gone on to basically become the entire franchise's, like, main composer at this point.
Okay, let's see.
Oh, that's fucking right. Catherine is technically a Megaton spinoff.
All right.
Cause yeah, that's the thing. Basically, an entire division of Atlas is just Megaton.
So when you go down, the floor number goes down, but when you go up, the floor number goes up.
Right.
So are you supposed to be going up, or are you supposed to be going
down? We're going down.
We're
going down a tower, because we started on the 8th floor.
Oh, okay.
It's like, it looked like it was like a ziggurat, where we went to the top of it, and like,
yeah,
the deeper down you go.
Yeah, that's the way it's designed, is just we started from the top, and we're going down. I do kind of wish we could get around to the Digital Devil Saga, in which it's Atlas tries to do Hinduism, and it's a very interesting, because it's like...
There's your...
You got this... You got things right that I didn't expect you to get right, but okay, this is going a direction I didn't expect. I also want an excuse to read the Avatar Tutor books, but that's...
Also, there seems like there's some sort of almost level scaling.
Yeah, I know. Like, I feel like maybe the reason we're not able to talk to some of the demons is because we're not high enough level.
That seems like it's the case, because as I've leveled up, I'm no longer able to, like, get through things. Okay, let's see. Let's do this. Okay, it's just gonna be 52. Let's, yeah, sure. So you're gonna be happy with that.
I think it's
locked.
Yeah.
Oh, here, I can just give it... There. I can do without the that thing.
Yeah, we have time magic.
Okay, it's writing down there. Oh, God, I hate the orientation of this.
Yeah, it's hard to read.
Oh, that's the elevator. Okay, that's what that is. There we go. Now we have Dryad.
Okay.
Oop, nope. Yep, and that's going to be our first boss. Okay, let's not do that.
What if you did it, but more?
Slightly frightening.
Never get cocky in a Megatain game. It will fuck you up.
Well, usually it's the game doing it, not just breaking. Yes, there are only four classes of monsters in this one. There's yes.
Mega 10 just sounds like a mecha.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah. Oh, but yeah, that's why Megami Tensei, it translates basically to goddess story. So the whole thing about her being Izanami is really important. And thus, Shin Megami Tensei is new goddess story, in which the goddess of said game is of varying importance depending on which game.
I like the one with the Australian shark.
I know you're telling a joke, but I had to think about that for a bit.
No, there's one with a Australian shark in it. It's like the first boss you fight.
God, now I gotta go remember what its name is now.
Patch.
It summons patches. Might be?
Okay, so now let's try something that the game, or this genre is also known for. Not the genre, this game. Leave this up here. Okay, let's see. We've got a Mythic and a Terran. Okay, so it's...
It's time for fusion!
Alright, demon breeding.
Let's see. So let's try... Gnome. Let's see, what do we get? Oh, okay.
That is a bog witch.
Let's see what else we can get. Okay, just get heck.
Yeah, but you'd also get three points to...
You also can't do it, apparently. Because you already have one. Let's try this. Huh. It seems like the other one would be... Like, this one, I bet you, is probably cheaper than the cost, or the cast.
Yeah.
Does it matter which one you pick first and second, or... No?
Yes.
Like...
Well, okay.
I don't think in this one it does.
Maybe not in this one. in general, yes. Is that the one you were talking about, X?
What? I think so.
Yeah, that's why I was confused when you said Australian, because yeah, this was it was in the Lesser Key of Solomon.
Yeah, but in the game, it's VA is Australian.
Ah, we're okay.
Getting a very bad Australian accent.
Okay, that's what threw me, because I thought you were talking about the actual boss itself being an Australian monster, and that's what was like.
Yeah, you know all those Australian demon sharks from Australia.
That seems like a downgrade. I don't know why I did that. Hey, K-Shizzle. Okay, let's continue down.
Yeah, you're right. That couldn't have been Nocturne then. I'm trying to figure out what game you saw that they gave Fornus an Australian voice actor. Because it's like, these games don't usually get voice acting.
Was it? Let's see. How much magnite do I have?
I'm trying to look it up, and I found an thing on game FAQs that just says which demon is your waifu. So I'm gonna keep scrolling.
Oh, wait, hold on 1 second. When did I get paralyzed?
I don't know.
Ah, during this fight, okay. You know what, let's run away from it then.
It's Digital Devil Saga. Because I only have two Shin Megami games on my shelf, and that's Persona 3 and Digital Devil.
Okay, that makes... Now I understand. That's because they turn into the demons in Digital Devil Saga, and that was just the character that had the voice actor that was doing an Australian... Digital Devil Saga is a weird, weird couple of games. It's very interesting and probably one of my favorites in the franchise, but just they're very weird.
Yeah. Nocturne's 3, right?
Yeah, Nocturne's 3.
But it definitely had a shark that spoke with an Australian accent, so that's all I remember.
And it's Persona, because I'm just trying to think of the reasons why I remember certain Batami Tensei. Persona 3 is the one in which you shoot yourself in the head, right? To summon
Yes, to summon the personas.
And then Nocturne is the one that had the lady with the breast of mouse in it.
No, that's Digital Devil Saga.
Oh, okay.
What you remember Nocturne is for Matador, the fucking boss that will always kill you. Because that's the first boss that tells you, no, this is a Shin Megami Tensei game. Shape up or you're gonna die. And also, Nocturne is also featuring Dante from Devil May Cry. Like I said, this franchise goes a lot of places. And then there's 4 and 4 Apocalypse in which... Oh boy, you ready for some deep cosmological arguments on the nature of godhood in the series and how it's fucking a lot.
Video games, it's fucking a lot.
Okay, Jewel. Okay, that's the elevator. guys be up again? Okay, let me see. Okay. On floor 6.
But yeah, the games get a lot more interesting once we get Shin and we have the Law Chaos argument, because it's always fun, because it's always the whole... Both of these options suck. It's a matter of how are they going to try and pitch it to you.
Yeah, because it's almost like with... It's almost like if you, like, think of it almost in, like, D&D alignment terms, it's almost like both of them are actually chaotic, it's just good and... Well, it's not even good and evil, it's more...
It's again, law versus... It's law versus chaos. That's what it is. It's more of, do you submit to an absolute authoritarianism, or do you become a libertarian? That's what the alignment is.
Wow, that's, like, the shittiest timeline of all.
Shin Megami Tensei games are not happy games.
They're not. Like, Nocturne is better about this because it actually... You as the Demi Fiend are trying to decide between a bunch of different people's ideological standpoints what to form the basis of a new world. But we'll get there when... Because since this game is in, Nocturne has also been grandfathered in. Nocturne is probably one of the better games in this... One of the better mainline games in terms of, like, philosophical discussion, but Nocturne's an asshole. Nocturne's a real fucking asshole.
Okay. So okay, they're in. Ooh, that's not good. Yeah, let's not deal with the zombies anymore.
I thought they only did, like, 1 point of damage.
They also apparently can do paralysis.
Oh, yeah, that's no good.
Darkness
like
is your ally.
Do not fuck around with status effects in these games. Let's see. The music's not bad in this game, it's just I wish there was a bit more to it.
Problem is that there is one for every area.
I figured as much.
And this is, yep, kind of forced out. That's an orc. Let's see, how bad is this gonna be? Fairy!
Okay, that's what it is. The last Bible spinoffs are basically Dragon Quest style. Instead of like the cyberpunk question mark?
Oh, it's a Lemurian.
Is this? So I'm curious now if the Risk of Rain enemies are based off of that.
I think a Lemurian is a like there is something that is a
run the fuck away.
No, talk to it.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to talk to us. I'm pretty sure that's a boss fight. Oh.
Good. Do we have 224 mag?
No, we don't.
But, what were you asking, Yannak? Sorry.
What?
You were asking something.
Oh, no, I was just curious if the Lemurians were in a Risk of Rain are based off of the Lemurian design.
So, Lemurians are one of the old conspiracy theory kind of stuff that goes around, makes the rounds, because the lost continent of Mu is thus Lemurian, is one of the kind of like Atlantis pseudoscience-y places that existed and thus was sunken upon the ocean, as one of the kind of super advanced technological races that existed in prehistory of time and things.
Yeah. Like, you guys know that Ys is a lost continent, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Common theme.
Oh yeah, because we have a dryad with it. They'll see it that the dryad will see that we have one. It's like, oh hey. Let's see how. Okay, that's at the end.
Pretty good drumsticks there.
I can force it.
Those lips, though.
Look, it's fine. It's not blackface. That's better than I can expect from. That's better than I can expect from a lot of games in this era, or even today, for that matter, from Japan.
I mean, I was just commenting on the fact that that tree has some thick, juicy lips, and
it's still...
Hey, we got Lemurian.
Yeah.
I just gotta make another one. Oop.
Oop.
Can someone check to see if my Twitch is up?
Yeah. Wait. Yeah, I see it.
Okay.
Yeah, things seem to be functioning fine. Yeah, Tyrion Sigler has many issues on his.
How many mag do you have?
Yeah, I probably should check that. 85!
Better start killing shit!
We gotta go find those pink things.
Hey, it's finally one of these things.
Ah, Nikamara! A series staple!
No, you're getting the mag. Oh.
You can't have a cat girl, Lolo.
Well, especially since it seems like...
Well, no. Try giving the maca, not the mag.
Yeah, cause let's try the. Oh, you. No.
So yeah. Wow, this is a lot more detailed than
I
expected.
Okay.
What did you have to do?
I just happened to have some liquor on me.
Well, then.
I'm kind of impressed. This is a lot more detailed than I expected for this early in the game, in like the series, just have these kind of branching dialogue trees this much for like.
So you're making forward progress in the story because your characters are secret alcoholics.
I guess.
But yeah, no, well, look, yokai in general, if you need to bargain with them, having booze is not a bad, guess, so.
Wait. Okay, let's, not deal with, okay, apparently killing that thing summoned a ghost. We don't want to deal with ghosts.
Sounds like a bad time.
Yeah, let's not deal with that.
Is there any way to, bargain with Cerberus with other stuff, or is it only Mag?
It seems like it was only Mag.
Naren, it's probably a reference to Thespani. I'm gonna be real. It's gonna probably be a reference to Thespani. Cause it's always a fucking reference to Thespani. Hello, it's me. I know too much about horrible, horrible conspiracy theories.
I feel like that's bad for your health.
It probably is, but I'm going into politics, so I clearly don't know what's good for me either way.
I'm sorry to hear that. I was asked by my local DemSoc chapter if I was interested in going into politics. And part of me was like, yeah, and then the other part of me is like, no, you know who you are, don't do this.
Like I said, like, well, yeah, you're right, yeah, I was thinking the timeline, yeah. Thespani did get its start around 1918, and while, Robert E. Howard only lived for 30 years, he was probably well-read enough to at least have heard of Thespani, but at least, vaguely.
Okay. I'm now starting to see the... What?
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 What? Bug. Bug.
Okay, we... That's great, because I don't know if this is actually a bug or if this is actually... No, no, let's not do
it. Oh, no, let's fight.
Yeah! Super good. Oh, there can only be three Kyries behind that, so I wouldn't fight it.
Okay, let's see. Mappa.
Mappa dappa doo!
Hello.
Oh. Well now.
Ah, a tyrant minotaur. You better get ready to fight.
Oh. Okay, let's see just how bad this is going to be. Take 5 points. Nope.
Nope. Welcome to Mega 10, motherfucker. It's time to show you to the door.
Probably should run.
Whew. Yeah, I was wondering, I'm like, okay, maybe I've leveled enough, maybe I'm good for it. No.
It's one of these. It's a wizardry game. Actually, leveling is kinda sucks in these.
Okay, well, let's. Okay, so let's. Okay, that worked. Okay, and I'm on floor. What?
Yeah, that is a good point. You haven't actually been summoning any of your demons.
That is true. But the thing is, if both the main characters die, it's game over.
Yeah, no, I definitely understand that.
Okay, what? I wonder if I do. Okay. How much magic sight do I have? 85. Oh wow, yeah, these. Yeah, it's a thing. Summoning your allies costs money.
Well, rip.
Let's just not deal with this.
Well, at least you have a Cerberus.
Yeah, except it cost all of my money to cast.
And Tyrion. I don't know about this game, but traditionally, no. They level up when you use them to fight. so I don't think they get.
I'm pretty sure you get them level up in this game by fusing.
Yeah, that's basically the more effective way to always. That's always even in games where they do gain levels by being in battles, they don't learn new skills unless you really fuse them all that much. So you are encouraged to take your demons and smush them together to get stronger demons.
It seemed like floor 5 was a good leveling spot if the enemies weren't complete nightmares.
Yo, apparently Bear can't see your video stream?
No, we've resolved that.
Okay.
Oop.
That's kind of annoying that Twitch is so flaky lately.
Yeah.
Well, granted, when is Twitch never flaky? Okay. It's just so I'm so used to having B be the button to go into a menu. In like this kind of thing. Yeah, I can imagine.
All right. Let's see what fun things we can do here. Let's try... I come on in the... Oh. Sure, let's try that. That's probably good. Oop.
I wonder what those, like, the different, like, stars between the thing mean.
It has something to do with, what they confuse with. Yeah.
Like I said, I have to say, I would probably never play this on my own time, but that's because this is archaic as hell. But this is fairly interesting to see that the entire series kind of design has basically been put together from the start.
Yeah. I mean, that's also kind of why I show this off, because, like, hey, here, you can see a little bit of it. About as much as you're going to want to see without actually, you know, seeing a full long play.
Yeah.
Is it here? Yeah. When you afford anything... Get helmets at least. Oh. That's right. Apparently Yumiko is the only one that can use helmets while Nakajima is the only one that can use shields.
Okay.
Let's see, what kind of... Let's see, how much maka do we need for new weapons? Quite a bit.
Seems like a lot of this is just grinding.
Yes. That is very much this kind of game.
Yeah, that's this genre. That's not what you can. That's what you can't really escape. God, I just. I'm surprised Yumiko hasn't gotten, like, any offensive spells yet. It's... Where's my Agni? Or my Zeos?
Okay, I took what you said in a completely different direction.
That's really... That is actually kind of weird.
Like...
Offensive spells?
Because clearly the naming is this, they have the same meta naming scheme even for the spells back
it
here
is,
too.
I think it is slightly different.
Yeah, though I don't, like, that might also just be like translations as well.
Could also be because yeah, I don't think like Bufu and those I don't think are in. Like it's actually neat because this fan translation patch actually came with a translated version of the manual, which lists all the spells.
Ah, nice. Five?
Let's have, okay, let's see how much damage one of them does. I think I'm gonna do one. Let's try those.
Well then.
Wasn't the end of the world.
16 ghosts appear.
Nah, we're running. We're running it. That happens.
Oh, wow. Okay, those things just are not taking damage. So how strong is a dryad? Pretty strong. Let's see how much... That is not worth it. Oops, that's not...
I keep sending in Soras, but no Rinkus.
Let's see. Let's try strength.
Why are you booing me when you know I'm right?
Let's try strength for you. Okay. Harpy. Let's try. Nope. Also, I think that there is also the thing I should have mentioned. There is also an SNES remake of this game. It's also combined with Megami Tensei 2. Which is basically more of the same. Oop, one second.
Yeah. Oh god, I forgot about that.
Doesn't leave us with any music.
It's fine. It's fine. It's just time to start vamping.
Vamping? Is that like you put blood in a cartridge and smoke it?
No, you see. Fuck, no, I broke that. Should have just gone with it. Oh well.
It's like vaping, but with blood.
I'm sure there's someone who's tried that.
God damn it. I don't want to think about that.
I mean, Theridos exists, so... Clearly.
Keep yourself young. Smoke blood. Shut up, Naren. I don't want to hear any of your logic. You and your facts.
Welcome back.
Oh, there we go.
We're talking about something very interesting.
Okay, let's not deal with the harpy.
Seems you activated the Harpy's trap card.
Actually, let me go down here, because I think this statue area we haven't been to yet.
Good to know. Hell yeah, bug!
Okay, let's not... I guess Lemurians just basically are not good to deal with.
Well, it would help if you healed.
Well, no, because... No, the thing is that they spawned, like... They always spawn a set of enemies afterwards.
Yeah. Seems like... Or... They seem to, or we just get really unlucky.
Well, it's a mythic Lemurian. So I wonder if there's a standard Lemurian and then a mythic Lemurian.
Nah, that's just the, like, species name kind of thing. Like, Haycat's mythic. Haycat. Because most playable, most, like, demons you can recruit have another word to designate type in front of their name.
Hmm.
There's usually a lot more, but there's only four in this game, is that some NPC rando we found said. Which, it might not be as noticeable in this patch, because of, like, character limitations. Because, again, Japanese characters will let you get away with a lot more, like, meaning in a shorter space.
Okay, let's see. Also, I just realized that for some reason on my bottom thing, the Twitch followers thing, is saying that I have zero followers.
Huh. Yeah, that's kind of a thing that's happening, because before Twitch was saying that people had nobody watching, but they did, and I think they're just having some weird API issues. Oh, no, see, it's back. It's 225.
Yep, there we go.
Is there, like, a major event happening today that might be drawing...
But now I don't have subs.
So what's the day ending and why? Nolan.
Okay, I'm gonna pause it a question to both everyone in here and also chat. Do we want to see something else?
I think we've gotten
as far as we can get.
Yeah, I think it's like, it's just going to be me grinding until we can beat that Minotaur. So,
Wizardry like JRPG? Full of grinding?
Yeah. So, yeah, I think we've probably seen enough of this.
Yeah, we've definitely. Like, I like this for what this is. I will never really want to play it.
Also, I want to point out that once you get through the first floor and beat the Minotaur, that's not the end of the game. There's still more.
Oh, yeah. There's like,
yeah.
There's several other things after that.
Yeah.
So I like it. What's the last Wizardly like that we played in?
Here's Wizardry 1, 2, and 3. Other Wizardry, they did Laplace's Demon, which is kind of a Wizardry like, and I would definitely say that.
Much.
Yeah, that's better.
That's better.
This would go under that.
I honestly have to say I'd probably play this over Tower of Draga.
Oh yeah, it's going somewhere in between. Like, I would probably put it, I'd put it below Xanadu.
Yeah, definitely below Xanadu. I don't know about Maze of Gallius.
Maze of Gallius, I'd probably actually put this below it.
I would rather play Binding of Isaac than this.
Yeah, I think, actually, now that I think, well, it's a good spot for it. Because I think Alone in the Dark is what I'm thinking. I'm like,
put it above Alone in the Dark, because this also seems more interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is less obtuse than Alone in the Dark, so I think that was a good spot.
I think in between Vampire Hunter D and Alone in the Dark is a good spot.
Yeah.
Oop.
It's a lengthened gameplay. This trades not knowing what the hell to do with grinding. And at least with grinding, you know you're doing something.
Yeah. I'd rather do something mind-numbing than just be completely fucking lost.
Alright, so
wow. So my Twitch sidebar just shows one person streaming.
Huh.
So yeah, they're just having stupid issues. Also, I'm hearing myself through somebody else's mic.
See, and this is a RPG.
Good old Erp Goods.
And technically it is based on a property, so it gets the dollars. Definitely more difficult. Okay. What is our likes slash dislikes?
I like the art.
Yep.
That's
good.
Yeah,
Raffy, you're echoing a bit.
I mean, I'm gonna jump right over to hate real quick and put in cheese.
Yeah, that. Well,
because the grinding is just.
We have something.
You have a pepper mill, I think.
Yeah, or something like that. Pepper mill.
I think.
Let me take a look at it.
Yeah.
That's damage spongy. I think this was the grinding one.
I can't.
It's like a tools.
Give it a shot.
Let's see there. Any of the other dislikes?
I mean, I'm kind of torn on the gameplay because there's some really interesting ideas, but obviously it's the first in the series, so they're not completely executed that great. So it's like, I like and dislike the gameplay at the exact same time. Okay.
Yeah.
It's definitely not aged super well.
See, that's always, I feel weird about saying that just because it's, the yes, its game itself hasn't aged well, but the core gameplay loop is basically unchanged for every other game in the series. So it's like a weird kind of, like,
The other games, I think, do a better job of mitigating that in with more interesting things going on.
Yeah, it's like there's more mechanics, quality of life additions, and things like that that sort of make the gameplay loop interesting.
Okay. Also, I just realized I did the thing that I hate about it, because it's not Digital Devil Saga, it's Digital Devil Story.
Oh, fuck, you're right. I didn't even notice that.
I thought it was Digital Devil Story Megami Tensei.
I don't think it matters which direction you put it. It's just, it's Megami Tensei.
Whatever. Yeah, Atlas is going to fucking keep track of that themselves.
Just going to go tag Atlas right now.
I'm trying to think if there's anything else. The music's okay. It's very repetitive.
It's repetitive. I can't give it.
Like, it's not bad music, but it's also just the same thing over and over.
You've rated it pretty highly, but you're also complaining about some of the grindy features. So I think that's about right. I mean, this shows promise, and I think the later entries will rank higher as a result.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because...
Because, again, we will never finish some of the later games, but when we get to things like Digital Devil Saga and Nocturne, I will be arguing for those games going into high blue, low purple, at the least.
Yeah.
So we should keep Carnival out of those streams at all costs.
Yeah, when we get there in 2035. Okay, so yeah, that's Megami Tensei Digital Devil Story. So, I'm on the stream for a little bit more, just to give us a little bit more pep. So I'm going to see actually if I can, I'm going to take a look to see what I have real quick.
Are you saving Laplace's demon for something else?
No, I've already done. We're as far as we're going to go with that. Let's see what I have in here. Well, no, because I'm thinking something in particular.
About a two-player 1001 Spikes.
Oh, let's try this. That was going to be weird, and I don't even know if this is going to work. Yes, they are. Actually, the first thing I am going to do is I'm going to do a save state here so I don't lose my progress. But I am going to do this. I don't even know if this is going to be the right game that I'm thinking of, but let's see if this works. That looks like it. Yep, that's it.
I could definitely read this.
So this is Megami Tensei Digital Devil Story for the MSX. This is the other game that I brought up.
Alright, let's... Ooh. Oh god! Ah, my eyes!
Oh no.
First off, let me update these notes. Because I believe this is also... so this is Telenet. And...
This is an assault on my eyes.
be found.
Well, how the hell are you supposed to see that?
I don't know.
This weird-ass watermelon floor.
Oh wait, does this mean the Mutant Novel Trilogy is now eligible for Media
yes.
Delta?
Yes.
Good. I gotta, when we do that one, I gotta be in.
Well, I was gonna probably do the OVA first.
Be found. Be found. This is vicious. Oh, those are stairs. I thought it was a scroll.
Nope. Damage. I don't know.
Yes.
Look. When you've been having a game series that's gone on for... Oh wow, it's been 20 years at this point.
I was gonna say, it's almost been 30.
Yeah. You go a lot of places with... You gotta go places with it.
Oh.
To keep making things.
Ah, good old damage.
Oop, that's...
Oh no. You got chased by a thing you can't see.
I wonder if there's a, like, if I do... I wonder if there's any... keyboard commands that I'm not seeing. Doesn't look like it. Also, naturally, since we're Izanagi, I believe the sword that we are using is the Kusanagi. Enemy popped out of the chest.
And insta-killed you.
Well, we already taken damage already. Okay,
oh.
I don't think...
What in the hell?
This is a password system.
I've never seen a password system use Greek letters before.
Okay, the song was doing that on purpose. I was confused there for a second.
Oh, I thought I was confused as well.
Just start putting in some characters.
Nor we could just do this.
I could do that.
Yeah, no, this is bad. This is
okay.
Bad.
I don't think that belongs in the same category.
No.
But let's.
Where do we put?
Do you have a garbage can category?
We have a garbage can spot, but let's see. I think this would go in resistance.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
So let's go right
scroll down.
To, yeah, scroll to red. Yeah, scroll to the red.
Oh wow, it's been a while since I sorted this. Let me fix that real quick.
Megami Tensei game?
Yeah, that was a Megami Tensei game. That was the other one it was Telenet Japan worked on that one. Okay, let's scroll down now. Oh boy, let's see. Okay.
God, I gotta...
Gotta sit down.
We gotta sit down and think about... What was... This is pretty bad.
So, I would probably at least put it above Mega Man DOS.
Yeah. I don't think I'd put it above Awesome Possum, though.
No, this is worse than Awesome Possum. I'll also say it's worse than... Well, it's going underneath Ernest Evans. I'd also say Marsupilami is a better game.
What about Hunt for Red October?
I probably would say that this is better than Hunt for Red October.
Okay, so underneath Marsupilami.
Yep.
It's pretty damning.
That game's not good.
That was not good. That was
I need to rewatch so you play that, because I remember missing that.
It lasted all 10 minutes, because that's all I could handle.
I beat it on the Game Boy. It was not a good experience.
That came out also in 1987. And that was by Telenet Japan. That's for the MSX. It's an action game that is based on... that. That is for research only. Now, do we just want to be lazy and say that we hate everything about it?
No. I hate the visuals. Like, that specifically I hate.
Visuals absolutely needs to be under there.
Yeah.
I put music under dislike because it was just a boring track.
Yeah.
And everything else is just bland.
Yeah.
I would probably just dislike the gameplay. It's not like, you know, the controls weren't responsive and it was like tedious and well it was tedious, but it wasn't impossible.
It's just 1987 computer schlock. It's essentially what it is.
Yeah, like the gameplay itself was nothing bad out of the ordinary. It was just that visual style was just a punch to the face.
Yeah. All right. Well, that is what they refer to as DDS Megami Tensei. So let me quick think of something else. I was trying to think because there was another game that I could think of that had a kind of similar presence. But what was the game that I was thinking of? I was going to say, we already did Jack Brothers, so we can't do that spinoff.
Jack Brothers is a good... fuck. Do you have either Demi Kids or Last... Well, do you want me to get you the spinoff list and you can pick anything that you might have?
Because I'm trying to think, aren't those all RPGs?
You're... Fuck. Ah!
I want a game that I can just do in, like, 50 minutes.
Oh, fucking... There's nothing really I can think of that's not like a fucking,
trying to think of a more thematic kind of thing.
Suggestions, but nothing that relates to anything that we've seen today.
There was a game that... You know, actually, hold on, I think I might know of a game. I don't know how long this is going to take, but I don't think it's a game that we have to see to the end. Let's see. I have the, this. I'm going to have to find a translation of this. I think I am. You know what? Let's, well, let me see if I can, I can get this real quick, because I bet you this is going to be a simple translation. Ooh. Oh, wait. It's not the game I was thinking of. Is there really not a translation for this? Oh. I guess there wasn't an English translation for this. Okay. Well, that makes it easier for me then. So I remember this game kind of being similar in style. Actually, you know, actually, how about this? Do we want to do more digital or do we want to do more devil?
Devil.
Devil.
Okay.
666 me, baby.
And Naren, you're right. Atlas doesn't do short games.
I mean, I could do Run Saber. That's better with two players. Because I remember this game having a kind of similar premise. Oh, this is Psycho Dream. Which
this
also...
is... This is SNES?
Yep.
Okay, Telenet, don't bleed our eyes this time.
Yeah, and this is specifically by the Riot branch of Telenet. Okay, let's see. Okay, let me just quick see this. Let me keep on normal. We have time wizardry powers. Let's see. Oh, we have a choice. Do we want to be Rio or Maria?
Maria. Maria.
From what I remember of the plot of this game is that basically you are taking part in an experiment to kind of go into someone's dreams, like as a medical procedure kind of thing.
So Paprika.
Not quite, but similar, yeah. I don't have whatever the hell that Metroidvania was called. It's like something synchronicity or something like that.
Unplayed old Metroid game.
Yeah, because they took that down because that there was some sort of thing with that. Oh, also. Ichinishi, why does that sound familiar?
Yeah, it does.
He was later hired by Square. Oh, it's because he is one of the people who worked at Love the Look. Okay. That's where, at least where I know him. He used to work at Square. Okay, this is a thing.
That's an outfit. Oh.
Okay, we are at Castlevania.
Do we have Dangle Whip?
No, we do not have Dangle Whip.
Oh. That sure is an outfit.
Actually, hold on, I need to take a look at something. Here, let me read the plot. In the early 1980s, rumors began to circulate about a new entertainment medium called D-Movie, which allowed people to immerse themselves in a world of virtual reality. As D-Movies gained traction, a trend emerges of disaffected young people taking permanent refuge in a digital virtual world while abandoning their physical body to atrophy. To relieve these so-called sinkers, Japan's National Public Safety Commission establishes Public Security Division 4, nicknamed Diamond Dog, in 1984, the agents who enter the virtual world and perform these rescues are known as debuggers. In 1992, a 17-year-old girl named Yuki Sayaka sinks into The Story of the Ruined Capital, a D-movie directed by David Viscotti. 3 days pass before she is discovered, and combined with a weak constitution, she is expected to die within 24 hours. Two debuggers, Ryo Shijimi and Maria Tobira, are dispatched to rescue her before that happens. So that what we saw actually in that little intro bit was actually the intro to the movie that this woman stuck in.
Wow.
That's a really weird hit noise.
Yeah.
Oh, also we have a new weapon.
New weapon.
If I hold the R, I can run. Oh, actually both triggers. I can. Oh. Take that hit, right? What is our weapon even?
It looks like claws.
Like a. Oh, now I've upgraded. We now spin.
Spin to win. Spin to win. What are you talking about, Tyrion? We have feet. We can't be a Liefeld character. They are still
also,
better made.
Also, it seems like there's a frame that in which all of her clothes disappear. Oh, it's just she has, like, it's like an apron. It's like, it's a Kentaro apron that she's wearing.
Okay, then. I guess they're taking on characters of the...
Okay, I guess I have magic. Or was I supposed to go this way? How else if I just go down? Oh, that definitely seems bad. Let's try and kill that thing in a spot where... Oh, okay, now what does this do? Okay, here's the thing I remember, because I remember there being some sort of butterfly thing, but this seems like That's not a... Also, there is some...
I think we gotta go in there.
Yep, that seems like it. Oh, that is not a good effect.
No.
We are incredibly mobile.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Oh boy, that's...
a thing?
Yeah.
Oh, and if I hold it down, then I can float down or hold jump. Let's see. Oh, okay. So that's what the FAT is. Is, I guess, fairy attack or something?
Yeah, something like that.
Also, our health does not seem to improve from level to level.
That's not good.
Okay, there we go. I got some health back. Okay. It seemed like that one that I picked up was more pinkish than the red one.
Yeah. At least I like the fairy power-up giving you, like, it's kind of cool, just... You start just blasting everything all around you.
Let's keep that for now. It seems like the other one is... See, that one's gonna... Yeah, that one's much more pinkish.
Spin to win.
It seems like this game is like... Seems like it's almost like... The thing's gonna run me over.
Yeah, no, same.
Oh no, then you get stuck in a universe where there's no anime.
That's a bus, not a truck.
Look, it's a big vehicle about to run you over. I don't think they're gonna really quibble over the how you got here.
Look, Truck-sama has very specific needs.
Truck-kun, thank you.
You better get their honorifics right, motherfucker.
I figure if it's a being that sends people other words, that's at least worth a sama.
I feel like I need to ask this question. Why are you collecting purple vaginas?
I think those are the time points.
Are they? What are they? I don't know what they're doing.
I know what I'm seeing.
Yeah, I think those are just score.
Yeah, the purple diamonds.
Sure.
Okay, we're fighting fetuses! Yeah, okay.
We're at the fetal stage.
I was wondering why this didn't get a US release, and the more I see, the more I realize.
Apparently somewhere out there is a prototype of this game that, like, the English version of this game, but it never came out. Obviously. Okay.
You know what?
Yeah! All right!
I don't think this would have gone over pretty well with the Blockbuster crowd.
Like, I mean, R-Type came out over here. It's not like...
R-Type is violent. This is weird sex.
Have you seen the... Like, go look up the Stage 2 boss of the first R-Type.
Yeah, but the protag in this is obviously in fetish gear, whereas R-Type is a spaceship.
That is true.
Look, maybe the ship was in its own fetish gear. You don't know.
Maybe. Well, we found the line. The line is somewhere between R-Type and Psycho Drain.
I just like that it spews fire. It really sells it.
Ah, God.
Later, it will start riding around in a chariot. And now we're in Goop stage.
I think this power-up completely nullifies any challenge that this stage had.
You know what? I'm fine with that.
This track right here sounds like something out of Secret of Mana.
Yeah, I can definitely see that.
I was wondering, if that flickering image supposed to be like your mirror image, or is it like a power-up?
Yeah, it's a mirror image power-up, I think.
Weird.
I didn't even notice it until you mentioned it.
I have to say, I like this game. This game's got interesting designs, I guess.
It's going for a thing, and it goes for it with gusto.
The only thing that I really don't like about this segment is that I have no idea what if I'm even doing something, the thing that I'm supposed to be doing.
You are. You're clearing out the thing spitting out stuff.
Okay, there we go. Okay, I see.
So it looks like you just gotta keep attacking either the things or the actual things shooting out the things?
Yep, that's what it looks like.
Oh, yeah, come things. On. God damn it.
Jesus Christ!
How to pad your game.
Man, you know what actually this makes me feel? This feels like... This is what I imagine playing a very geared out Huntress in Risk of Rain 2 feels like.
Ah, you're right. You are right. Too bad Torpid's not here to confirm this, but yes.
Yeah, I've said a few times myself when playing some games where sections either goes on too long or you keep dying, but you get the gist. There needs to be just like an option after a certain period where the game's like, yeah, I think you've got the idea. Do you want to skip this crap? And then you could just skip the crap and move on.
Okay, there we go. We got one down at least. I think the thing is I need to actually get close up to it in order to do more damage.
Hmm. Like, there's no nobility or skill in suffering through a tedium or just uninteresting stuff. And I know there's, like, a weird subsect of people who play video games that take a sense of pride in it, and I don't get it.
Well, the thing is that so I actually am there. I have a like a short range attack that is what I need to be doing in order to hit the things at the bottom.
Okay, that hurts you, apparently. There's somebody in there. Oh no, Mothra!
Wow, that boss... I hope that's not the only phase.
Oh no, Jennifer! Okay.
I guess that was the girl we need to save.
I guess.
Bored being our own game.
I mean, this is really happening. Oh, are we in Central Park?
I don't think so. Does Central Park have soccer trees?
Sure. I don't know, I've never been there.
I know DC does, but...
Look, the only thing I know about Central Park is everything I've seen in Spider-Man games.
I thought for just a half a moment they were going to say everything that I've seen in Trolls in Central Park.
I've never seen that, actually.
Probably for the best.
I will be watching Troll 2, I think, the end of this week.
I was going to say, have you seen We're Back?
Yeah, everybody's seen We're Back.
I bet you it's almost exactly like that.
But with way less dinosaurs.
Yes.
Unfortunately. I want a T-Rex friend now.
Please do not go back in time and distract dinosaurs. It only... Time travel only leads to bad things.
No, see, look, I'm going back in time. I'm bringing back a Velociraptor and a T-Rex, a Triceratops, and a Brontosaurus. Because the Brontosaurus is real, and you're not taking that from me.
No, they're not.
Shut up!
A land before time would not lie.
Exactly! Exactly!
The paleontologist in me is angry.
And it's no. T-Rex. Fuck you.
No, we just missed. We messed up with those bones. They fucking.
Right. It's gonna. I'm gonna name him Thomas Rex, just like Tyrion said.
Stage and then, 2.
And the Brontosaurus, nope. I'm going to name Taily. That's spelled like Haley, but with a T.
Okay.
Because they got a long tail.
Oh, good. No, it's an auto-rugging segment.
Oh, good. This is good.
This is a... I guess... Huh, this is definitely a game.
Oh, right, I don't need that.
Oops, see? Look at that.
You're fucking kidding me. What?
Look at that. Brontosaurus is a real thing! Suck it! Never question me. I am always correct.
Bullshit.
Correct by doing the math problem the complete wrong way, but still getting the answer right.
Exactly. Thank you, Nolden. You are my new favorite person.
All right, I stand corrected. But...
Turns out they actually didn't have feathers. That was just someone trying to make a goof. Though, to be fair, I really want more media to do feathered dinosaurs because they look awesome.
Oh, I know. It's way cooler to have the feathers instead of just the... It, because, but no, everyone wants to do the Jurassic Park, but that... Like, I'm not even mad at Jurassic Park for making that one... Making that... Because that was what the current science said. But no, do the fucking feathers. Like, yeah, I will be fine admitting when you give me proof that, oh, I was wrong. Yeah, but...
Also, one thing I hate about this game is that sound effects just sound like they do not coincide with whatever they are supposed to match with.
Right.
Cheat mode enabled or something?
I mean, I don't think so. This is on normal.
Decreasing at all.
Well, no, it's because that sound effect is from me killing enemies. It's not me taking damage, because me taking damage has a completely different sound effect. Okay, this is the song you're gonna go with, sure.
It's perfect. Whoop, don't worry whoop. About it.
Oh. That was an abrupt.
Just get a train up your ass. That I guess that whoop. Works too. What? Okay. Wait, what the hell is going on?
It's a dream.
No, no.
Oh no! I think I see what it's gonna do.
Oh no.
I guess I'm just gonna walk up.
this game.
Right there, you were flashing when the fire hit you, but your health bar is still full.
I think that is sprite point flickering.
I think we've seen enough at this point, because if this level's gonna do some maze bullshit...
I think we're going to new... Oh. Do we have to protect the payload?
I think you gotta protect the payload. Okay, but what if the T-Rex not only had feathers, but fur?
My god, you actually lost a hit point.
Just like a fuzzy T-Rex. And it didn't, like, roar so much as it, like, cawed very loudly.
I mean, isn't that what... haven't they said... like, wasn't there a thing that said, like, hey, this is what T-Rexes are actually supposed to sound like? And it was supposed to be very shrill.
I wouldn't be surprised, but I don't know any articles off the top of my head.
What do you got for us, Nolden?
Now we literally are in Salamander. What the hell?
I see we've hit the vor level.
Or meat level, but yes.
Yeah, we're in the meat.
This is the brain. This is the greatest as hell. Okay, you can't do that! You can't just take the lava flare! Straight, Konami's gonna be mad!
Boy, this game is going places.
It's starting to be a dream, but...
It's Magma Worm!
That is a Konami solar flare, what the hell?
Something or lives.
Okay, Nolden does have an article about T-Rex real sound.
And see, it's got a dash between the T and the Rex, as it should be.
Link.
Mostly saying this just to, like, drive Carnival insane.
Where's the... on, where's the sound thing? Where's the link to the sound? And the...
Vaughn,
load the telegraph! All the roar sounds like some kind of bass beat. That's it. Ah, okay. That makes sense then.
So T-Rexes were basically just like Barry White.
What? Oh.
Oh.
Wait.
Oh. That's a boss music. Okay.
All right. Okay.
What is the name of this? I can't remember, but
it's Ave Maria.
Oh, yeah. Fuck.
That's... Okay, I kind of actually like this.
This is a good choice here. Okay, game. Come on now.
There's somebody in its stomach.
That's the girl we're trying to find. And...
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Okay, game, you're okay in my book. You had a theme, and you decided to just go all in.
Okay, I think I need to be this form in order to do damage, it seems.
I really don't know how you're supposed to do this.
I mean, we're doing damage to the thing. Actually, if I... Didn't seem to do much damage, but... Oh, we did some. There's just... Wow, that is a...
It's just random... angles.
It's
based on where you're standing.
This one's... Okay, yeah, now we're doing natural damage to it.
We still got, like, four more of those full attacks. So we might as well... This looks pretty final bossy, so I think we can probably...
Probably, yeah. Oop.
Phase 2.
Oh god. It's terrifying.
Well then, that was a game.
That was a fever dream having a nightmare.
Still the best game of the session, but...
Yeah.
Hmm.
Director of Designer.
I have eaten cheese before bed and never had dreams like this.
Creature designers, all three of you. Good job.
Especially on that first one, the deck moth.
But yeah, no, like I said, this is definitely was interesting.
Yeah. I mean, it had an aesthetic and it ran with it constantly. And it worked. Worked out real well.
I like this track, actually.
Yeah. I was just wondering, it was like, where it was going with that.
I'm all about flutes. This is a good flute. Okay, please stop that. No.
Yeah, I think that's it. All right, well, I'm curious about something.
Oh, you're gonna see how
Rio plays. Okay.
I'm sorry. What is this fucking Toku ass fucker?
Curious, what is his? Okay.
So this is a thing. I don't know why, but for some reason this is making me think of Skull Jagger. Which I assume absolutely nobody on the planet has played.
I have not.
I mean, you're not missing much. It was a pretty bad game.
What?
He's now got blades on his shoulder or elbows that spin around in a circle.
I mean, same.
Oh, now he's got him on his shins, too. That's...
Now just...
This game clearly goes by the ethos of spin to win.
If you run into me, it's your own fault.
Really barding it up now. This is the greatest game.
This is a good game.
This dime store Dr. Doom looking ass. Awesome.
Okay, that's fun.
Does this change at all? No.
Can't you just jump down?
No, because not here. I have to wait for... We have to kill everything.
They definitely had fun.
Oh, yeah. Oops, I think I went too soon. Also, oh, right, this is the one where you had to go in the center thing. Oh, right, this area. Okay, you know, I don't think I want to go through this area again. Alright, I think we've seen
looks
enough.
Looks very unpleasant.
Alright.
So that's definitely a purple tier.
Well, let's see, let's see what we got at the big intro of the purple. Star Fox 2, and Capcom Disney Aladdin.
It's not better than Cuphead.
Yeah, I would not put it better than Cuphead.
I had a joke, but it died in my head. I'm not gonna fight you on this.
I would also say that I think Last Flirt's a better game. Also, probably Disney's Aladdin and Star Fox 2.
Yeah.
Really?
I would say it's better. I think Star Fox 2 is a better game.
I think it's better than Innsmouth, though.
Better than Innsmouth? Because I was going to say, I think it's better than Comic Zone. So it's going either above or below Innsmouth. I can see it being above Innsmouth, so yeah, that's probably a good spot for it.
Man, it's nice when you just these random-ass games turn out to be like, oh, this was actually really good.
I remember hearing a lot about that, but I've never actually played it, so... It was actually interesting to see that it's... not bad. And let's call that... confusing.
Trippy.
Yeah, let's call that that. And...
It's a bit above, like, a general audience, but not too far.
I'll still put expert. I think that's closer to what it was.
Yeah.
Okay, so... I mean, like visuals.
Yes, visuals.
I would say this is a Love Charm game.
Yeah, the charm is great.
Do you have, like, a special award for most superfluous and nonsensical backstory?
I can say like story. One thing I will say.
Just get over this huge paragraph backstory you read out of the manual that has nothing to do with the game.
I mean, we still rescued the girl, so it made sense.
Sound effects are not good.
Yeah.
Did we rescue her, like, in the middle of the game but kept playing anyway?
I think she flew away.
Yeah, she flew away and then he rescued her again from the giant orb monster.
Alright, well, I think that's good for Psycho Dream.
Yeah. So,
there's that. So, that was a fun look at the original Shin Megami Tensei, or the original Megami Tensei. Remember we were doing that? Alright, yeah. So that's enough of that. So that brings us to this episode to a close and to next episode, which is, boy howdy, is it a doozy. So. So, if you're watching this on YouTube, you can, or if you're watching this on Twitch, you can follow my YouTube by going to youtube.ldp.life. That will take you to my YouTube channel where you can, you know, watch these at your leisure. If you're watching this on YouTube itself, you can go to my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/hellothepuzzlo or twitch.ldp.life. That will take you to, I'll take you to the Twitch page where these episodes are recorded live 7:30 Fridays at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Saturdays at 2:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and Sundays at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can also follow the show on Twitter, my personal channel, at LilithPuzzle, and the show's Twitter, at HazeltownStory. You can also join the Discord server, which they can chat with the community, and also take part in polls when they go live. Their polls usually go live at the end of the month, where I determine, not the next month, but the month after, what games to take a look at for there. There is now also the Patreon, which you can go to patreon.ldplife. There are $2 and $5 tiers, of which that will go towards hosting costs and other kind of art upgrades for the channel. So, with that, thank you all for watching. Next Friday, Master of Unlocking Genres, in which we take a look at the first Resident Evil, which I'm sure... Because I don't want to go remake straight up, because I do want to show off like the original PlayStation version. And I'll probably do the remake at some other point. I think I'm going to be doing the director's cut, so we can hear more of this lovely fart trumpet in the basement. Yeah. Also, I kind of want to see what the DualShock version is, because I've never played that, and I want to kind of see how that works. But yes, that is next Friday. I believe Bear should be streaming very shortly, in which he's going to be taking a look at the Mega Drive Mini, which should be rather interesting. So I'm going to send you all to him.
I think they just started.
So I'm going to pop that on. So go ahead and join him. That should be a fun stream, because that thing is really good. So
be sure to be here for the next episode, or you'll be a Jill sandwich.
Or Chris something.
Yes. Boulder Puncher.
A Monte Cristo.
Love it.
All right. Anyway, I think I have to end the stream now. So later.
Later.